I'm CeAnn Jocker, and I am going to show you how to make a pigtail for helicopters, and they also can be used for right stuff. And what you're going to need is a set of pliers that are the rounded ones, like this, and regular pliers. And then I like to use these clipping ones. These you can get much closer when you clip instead of using the cutters, the wire cutter that's on the pliers. All right, we're going to get started. This over here on the left shows the progression of how we're going to get to that. So you'll hopefully be able to follow along with there, and I'll stop and go back and show you where I'm at. First of all, we're going to take a 25,000th music wire. And this is going to be our mandrel that we're going to be turning it on. And then the other one is going to be 20,000ths music wire. So first thing we're going to do is we are going to bend the 20,000th wire into a little bit of an angle. So you that right there, that first step. Then we're going to hook it around the mandrel like this. Now, keep in mind, I am left-handed, so you will be doing it. These here are showing kind of a little bit of a right-handed. Either way will work. Okay, so I've got it caught over top of the mandrel with the back there, and it doesn't matter. That needs to be doesn't need to be right connected down there. This is just so you can grab a hold of it with the pliers. So right now I am holding this to the mandrel with the pliers, and that's given me the ability to go ahead and start wrapping. We're going to start the first part of this where we're wrapping the 20,000ths around the 25,000ths music wire. And you're going to go around it one time. And as you wrap it, you want to try to get those wraps real close, the second one around. And then come around a second time. So I'm wrapped around two times. So now we are at this point right here. Okay? So I'm going to take this off, slide it off of the mandrel, and I'm going to clip off this tail end there that we don't need. And that's where these clippers come in really handy. You can get it real close to get it clipped. And you want to cover it because that's metal flying, and you don't want that little metal piece flying. Okay, that's gone. And now we are at this step right here. So we're to that point. And if you notice, there's a little burr, a little end piece. We're going to bend the wire right here, the loop. We're going to bend it with that on the inside. So I'm going to take the pliers, hold on to it, and we're just going to give it about a 45 degree bend. It can be even closer to the loop. But you want to make sure that cutoff end is on the inside. And let's stick the mandrel back into it. And try not to pinch it too much so that you don't close the hole up. So now you're at this point right here. I know this is bent a little bit more. It can be as close up to the top or right down here, a little bit of a bend. That's fine. So next is going to be coming down to here. We're going to make a bend at the bottom. Just a little bit, so this is going to be the V upward. Put our mandrel back in. Get my mandrel back in there. I think I've got it stuck. This is important on this part, that you want to make sure that this piece here is not being forced up against the mandrel. If it's way far out, you've got to bend this piece right here a little bit more so that they're pretty much in alignment. Otherwise, it's going to be real tight. All right, so once you get it to this point, you're going to hold, again, the two pieces with pliers very loosely. This one was a tight loop surround. This is going to be loose, and this is the end of the pigtail. Relatively loose. I know this wire is kind of tight, but okay. Now, hopefully, oh my goodness, look at that, it worked. I should be able to spin it, if I'm able to spin it, because your motor hook is going to be going through here and it needs to be spinning freely. Sometimes it doesn't work that well and you have to do a few adjustments. You may have to loosen this a little bit. Sometimes to get it to be able to spin, you might even have to turn this little loop tilted a little bit so that there's total alignment between these two. All right, so we've got it now at this point. The last thing to do is pull that out, and we're going to clip off the end. Leave a little bit of the pigtail, the pigtail here. About that much. And again, I am going to cover it with my hand so we don't have pieces flying. Like that. And you have your pigtail. Sometimes you can bend it in a little bit closer down here. I don't want to bend this one any tighter, because if I bend it tighter, then it's going to be out of alignment. Now the final check to be sure that it's loose. Remember, we were using 25 thousandths for the mandrel. The motor hook is going to be 20 thousandths. So sometimes if it's really tight, you can just go ahead and stick your 20 thousandths and it spins really freely. Okay. Now, next I am going to show you, so we have that done, your pigtail. Now I'm going to show you how to make the motor hook. This is where I use the rounded pliers. If you don't have rounded pliers, you can still do them with regular pliers and make a little diamond at the top. But this is a shepherd's hook that we put on the top. First thing I do is I take, again, this is 20 thousandths wire. I make just at the very tip, make just a little curve, okay? You can see that little curve there. And then I go right below that, and I'm going to curve it the opposite way to start my loop around the round pliers. Take that all the way around. It's going to be a little bit tight, but that's okay, because the next thing you're going to do is you're going to come down here and you're going to bend it back this way. Now the reason you're doing it this way, you're making that extra little bend, is because your motor, your O-ring, should be centered on the shepherd's hook so that it's coming in alignment with the rest of the motor hook. If we left it without this extra hook, your motor is going to be off center of your motor hook, of the motor hook. You'll see at the end we have an additional little hook there, and that's to wrap around. This one is would be for helicopters, and that's so that it wraps over the end of your rotor. In that case, what you want to do is make just a little tiny bend, a little bend, and then we're going to make a second bend, just a short one. Now, when you slide this over your rotor, this is going to be able to latch it on so it's not going to, this will cause your rotor to turn, that it's not just going to be your motor stick, but not your motor stick here. All right, let's put these two together. When you are putting these on, you're going to have beads on this too. You're going to, first of all, do it backwards. This is the front. You're going to hang this over. Loop. I looped it the wrong way. Got to come in through the front. loop it in like this, down like that. Then you're going to go and take your shepherd's hook and loop it on to the end on the inside. Make sure you go on the inside, not on this side. You want to go on this side of it. Slide it up, rotate it, and when I rotate it, it should slide right in. There it is. Yep, I didn't make that tail end enough. It slipped off. Operator error here. Keep going. Come on. Make some adjustments on this one, which I think I need to flatten this a little bit more. Fits in there. You've got your O-ring and rubber band is going to be attached to this end. This is the front, and your rotor is going to be up here. If you're using it for helicopters, you want to make sure that this is long enough so that you can put your bead right here, beads here, and this is going to be long enough that it will attach and go over the top of your top rotor. If you're using this for right stuff, this end will be, this right here will be shorter, and your rotor will be attached here. Similarly, it'll have the same kind of a hook like that. So now let me do one more thing I need to show you, and it's the tail hook. This is a very simple thing to do on the tail hook. This again can be done out of 20 thousandths, or you can make it out of 25 thousandths. And this is for the back, if you're not going to have a double rotor, if you're going to have just the back hook, it's an S plus a tail. So you're going to make a bend, and then you're going to make another bend. So we're this way. And then you're going to make a back bend. Start of an S, you see it starting. And make one more. And you have your S, although again, I'm a lefty, so there's your S. And then we're gonna make one more bend, which is the part that's gonna go into your motor stick. Now, sometimes kids say, how come we have to have it this extra little bend? Why can't we just make one? I'm going to cut it off right here. Because you want to get your back hook. Again, I'm going to cover it. You want your back hook to be elevated. Because your hook is, your O-ring is going to go into this part right here. And you need to have this much space at least elevated above the motor stick, because when you put this on your motor stick, let's do this up here, maybe down a little bit lower. You want your O-ring in the front and your O-ring in the back approximately the same height. Actually, ideally, they should be at the same height from your motor stick. This part of your pigtail is going to be buried, it's going to be slit and glued into your motor stick. So you need to put this little extra part down here. You could also put a block of a piece of wood and elevate it, but this helps to make it strong too. All right, if you have any questions, you can always, you know, email or check with the national office and they'll get a hold of me. And hopefully this will help you and your students to be able to make pigtails.